As oil prices bite and a faltering economy makes grocery budgets rise, urban farming is gaining increasing popularity the world over. Today, onions, for example, a staple in Indian diets, have touched 80 rupees a kilo. How is an average family in a city going to survive in these conditions? People from all walks of life and ages are coming together to learn how to grow food in balconies and rooftop gardens in order to become more self-sufficient.
Here in Makran Society, we've had our vermicompost projects for about 6-7 years in the society. What we decided was we used as many local resources that we had and we set up this open farm. We started off with maybe about 20 to 30 pots. However, like every project, we do have a certain set of problems that we face.
Watering is a big concern for me because checking the moisture level and watering as per that is very essential.
Another major problem that we face is the weeds that grow. Apart from affecting our plants, they also cause many skin diseases when we try to pluck them out. And the insects, both of them cause itching.
We do feel that technology can be put to good use in clearing our problem.
Yes, indeed. Engineers can help. Robots can help. Think about it. Robotic helpers working for us. Planting seeds, watering seedlings, taking care of plants till harvest. IIT Bombay's E-Yantra National Robotics Competition helps you learn the necessary skills to make automated urban farming possible. Seeding robots, weeding robots, harvesting robots, all aimed at making it easier and cheaper for us to grow food where space is available to us. Take part in the E-Yantra Robotics Competition. Log on to www.e-yantra.org.